Hi Bruce, it's Randy here from Randy Cycle Service. I'm sitting on your BSA 441 Shooting Star right now. Got it all done up and getting it ready for you to pick up. Just going to run through the starting procedure. Now, I've already had it started cold, so I don't need to tickle the carburetor or anything like I normally would, but I'll still show you the basics of that. First of all, we turn the gas on. Right-hand petcock over here is the on petcock, so that's on. Left side is reserve. We don't need that right now because we've got a full tank of gas. What we're going to do then, if it's cold, we would hit the tickler on the carburetor, hold it down for a few seconds until we see a little trickle of fuel come out of the side. Again, since it's warm, I don't necessarily need to do that, and it's about probably 75, 80 degrees out here right now. Engine has been running, so warm enough. The starting procedure on the single is a little bit different than what you're used to with a lot of other bikes. Obviously, we're kickstart only. We have a compression release underneath the handlebar here, which we need to use. What you're going to do, the procedure on this is a pretty easy starter every time. I usually roll the kickstarter through very slowly until I feel compression. When I get to compression, I'm at top dead center. I pull in the compression release just a little bit. That lets it go just past top dead center, and then when I kick it through, I get a full 2 revolutions, and then it starts easily like that. Cold, usually second kick, sometimes warm, takes about 3 kicks is typical. But again, good running bike, everything's right the way it should be, so I'm going to show you that procedure. So now everything's set, key is on. I'm going to roll it through compression. I'm almost there. Again, the singles don't have to necessarily be a hard starter as they're rumored to be. If they're done right, that's the way they should be. We're going to take off on a little ride and show you how everything works.